Good morning. Welcome to another exclusive video, this time biology. I'll be differentiating three terms that are very closely related, used together most times, and commonly confused. I'll tell us their meanings and I'll tell us an easy way of differentiating all three of them. Now, the three terms are tropism, taxis, and nastism, and there are three types of responses that we see in organisms. So usually organisms respond to stimuli in one of these three ways, any one of the three. Now, this tropism, some refer to it as tropic response, taxis, tactic response, nastism, nastic response. Now, how do we know if a particular response is tropic, tactic, or nastic? I'll differentiate them on two legs. When I say two legs, I mean using two different criteria or parameters. The first one would be whether the response is directional or non-directional. If we say directional, okay, there's a stimulus, the response is toward the stimulus or away from the stimulus, that's directional. And then, in the case where it is undirectional, it means there's a stimulus and the response is not necessarily towards or away from the stimulus. I'll give examples as we proceed. Then, the second leg, as it were, on which I'll differentiate these three, would be whether it is the entire organism that responds or just a part of the organism that responds. Now, having said that, straight to business, in terms of direction, tropism is directional, nastism is undirectional, taxis is directional. Which means the type of response that is undirectional is nastism. Then in terms of whether a part of the organism moves or the whole organism moves, what we have here is part, this is whole, and that is part. Now, commenting on the first term for differentiation, which is directional, when a response is directional, it means that when we begin to describe that response, eventually we'll be using terms like positive or negative. When do we say a response is positive and when is a response negative? When we respond by going towards the stimulus, we call it positive. And then when we respond by moving away from the stimulus, we call it negative. Then, another thing I should tell you is, using tropism, for example, maybe we should pick an example of each of these, and this will help us to, you know, see these three terms that we have mentioned. Now, for tropism, let's say we have a plant like this, and that plant is growing inside a box, all right? Now, this box is completely sealed. Of course, the plant will not even grow in the first place. But if there were a hole somewhere here on the box, now typically plants grow straight. But in this case, because there is light coming from that source, you find that this plant begins to tilt towards that direction so as to grow out of the box. In that case, the stimulus that this plant is responding to is light. Light came from there, and what did we find the plant do? Go in that same direction. We found it going in that same direction. So we say, because the plant moved toward the stimulus, which is light, we will add positive, all right, because it's going towards the stimulus. Then what kind of stimulus did it go towards? Light. So we say photo. Then, will it be phototropism, phototaxis, photonastism, photo what? What kind of response is it? Let's find out. We already know it is directional. in that it went toward the stimulus. So it cannot be nastism. We are left with these two. This is either phototropism or phototaxis. So the next question would be, is it the entire plant that went after light or a particular part of the plant that went after light? It's a part, just the top part, the shoot. What about the root? Did the root really go after the light? No. As a matter of fact, roots are known to move away from light. So based on that, because it's just a part of the plant that went towards that stimulus part, that makes it tropism. So what I have just described now is positive phototropism. Now imagine that perchance it happened that upon putting this plant inside this box and creating that hole, the plant that had been growing upwards made a U-turn and started growing downwards. It will still be tropism because it's a part of the plant that is responding. It will still be phototropism because the response is to light, but it will now be negative phototropism. Now imagine this, an organism like the amoeba. When the amoeba is in water, let's say we'll give it that shape, that's an amoeba for now. When it's in water and you shine light towards that water, strong light, what does the amoeba do? It swims away from the water. Now, that it swims away means that I am going to bring in a first word, which is negative. The stimulus it is responding to is strong light. That means I'm going to add photo, all right? So that's photo there. Then beyond the photo, am I going to add tropism, taxis, or nastism? Well, I would now ask myself, that it is negative means it is directional. Can it be nastism? No, but it will definitely be one of these two. Now, when the light came, did a part of the amoeba move or did the entire organism move? Of course, the entire organism moved away from the light. So when the whole moves, it becomes taxis. So this is negative phototaxis. So taxis is directional, can be negative or positive, and involves the whole organism moving. But in the case of nastism is not in any particular direction, that is not towards or away from the stimulus. And then also nastism involves movement of just a part of the organism. Now look at this. There's the plant called the morning glory. For this morning glory as a plant, when light intensity is low, its flowers do not open, they close. But when the light intensity becomes high, they open up. So in that case, they are responding to light, but they are not moving towards or away from the light. They just give a response to the light. You understand? The same thing happens with the mimosa plant, Mimosa pudica. This mimosa, when you touch the leaves of the plant, what happens? From being open like that, the moment you touch them, they close. So what are we trying to say now? By touching the leaf did not move toward your hand or away from your hand. Instead, what happened? It closed. So we say that response is not directional. It is more like an undirectional response, and such is referred to as nastism. So nastism is very different from these other two in the sense that it's not in any direction. So we cannot have positive or negative attached to nastism. But for taxis and for tropism, yes, they can be positive and negative. Think too of a sperm in the reproductive tract of a woman. When a sperm is dropped in the reproductive tract of a woman, it is possible that it begins to swim towards the egg. Like in some organisms, there's evidence that the egg attracts the sperm. So in that case, we say that the attraction from the egg is a stimulus, and the sperm running towards it, yeah, that's directional. So we'll call it what? Positive. And is that tropism or taxis? Yes, it is taxis, because it involves the whole sperm moving, not just the part of it. So in summary, tropism, taxis, nastism, these two are directional, that's undirectional. These two involve parts, but that involves the whole. And I'll tell you another simple clue you could have is the fact that taxis occurs in animals, because it's only in animals that you can have the whole moving. In a plant, the whole cannot move. So taxis is exclusively for animals. The other two, yes, can be found in plants. But can animals also exhibit the other two? Well, to some extent, yes. But this one is their property strictly. So it is my hope that after now, you'll be able to differentiate these three things on those two legs like I did. Thanks for watching. Don't fail to subscribe, please. Once you're done watching a video like this, leave comments. Where you see something wrong, feel free to comment. You have observations, feel free to comment. And of course, I'll appreciate all of them. And then again, remember to like the videos and to tell people who are not subscribed to this channel, friends of yours who may benefit from the content of this channel, to subscribe to it so that they are also in the know like you are. Thank you.